Hello guys, welcome to today's class. Now this is a special episode for the exam. What I'm going to be doing here is to provide solutions to the examination questions. Is to do what? To provide solutions to the examination questions. So what I will want you to do is always come here every day, because I'll be uploading new videos every day so that you get current with what the latest video. And also I will plead with you not to share this video to any of your friends. I guess you can't, because they have to request access before they can get to this platform. And also invite them so that they can register. When they register, we'll bring more new exciting videos. So in this lecture, we are going to be looking at the Chem 231 past question, which is physical chemistry, which seems somehow difficult. But at the end of this lecture, you see that it's very, very easy. Now, we are going to take it question by question. Please make sure that you have this thing with you. When school resumes, I'm going to distribute it to everybody. But for now, you can just make do with it. Are we getting it now? This question. The first question says, mathematically, Boyle's law can be represented as. Now, we have different types of gas law, or different types of law that explain the behavior of gases. These laws are, we have the Boyle's law, the Charles law, the Darting's law of partial pressure, the Gay-Lussac's law, then we have the Avogadro's law. Now, the Boyle's law. The Boyle's law states that pressure is inversely proportional to volume so long temperature is kept constant. Now, what does the Boyle's law say? Boyle's law says that at constant temperature, the pressure is inversely, please note, the pressure is inversely proportional to the what? To the volume at constant temperature. Now, mathematically, we can say that Boyle's law is given as P is proportional inversely. When you say inversely, it means 1/what? The volume. So the pressure is inversely proportional to volume. This is the mathematically notation of Boyle's law. Now, if you change this mathematical symbol here, what are you going to have? You have P, or this proportionality, if you change it to equal to, you are now going to introduce what? A constant K. You are going to introduce a constant value of what? K, because you are removing this alpha from here. So this becomes K times 1/V. And this becomes P is equals to K times 1 is what? K over V. K, this is over 1 also. So this multiplied by this, your K will be equal to P V. So this is the mathematical representation of Boyle's law. It's either you represent it like this, or you represent it as K is equals to PV, or PV is equals to K. Now, you have the options. Now, it can either be, or it can be in either ways. It can be in what? Either ways. It's either the pressure is inversely proportional to volume, or we can say that the volume is inversely proportional to the what? To the pressure. It is either the pressure is inversely proportional to the volume, or the volume is inversely proportional to the pressure. So, taking it this way now, volume inversely proportional to pressure. For pressure inversely proportional to volume, the volume carried 1/. Now, for volume inversely proportional to pressure, pressure will carry 1/. So, this can be also be written as what? Volume is inversely proportional to pressure. Is that clear? Volume is inversely proportional to pressure. Here you can remove the proportionality sign, and this becomes V is equal to. Whenever you are removing the proportionality sign, you put equal to and introduce what? K times 1/P. Now this becomes V is equals to K times 1 is what? K over P. And at the end of the day, what are we going to have? This is over 1 also cross multiply. P times V will give us PV. 1 times K will give us what? K. So our values are PV is equals to K, or you can have it as V is equal to K over P, or V is equals to what? V is inversely proportional to 1/P. So if you look at the options given to you, you said A, V is that inversely proportional to what P, which is this. This is a mathematical representation of Boyle's law. Then we have B. V is equals to K over P. That is what we have here. V is equals to K times 1 is what? K over P. It's a mathematical representation of Boyle's law. Then C, VP, which is also PV, you see that you call it PV or VP, is equals to K. So you see that all of them are mathematical representation of Boyle's law. So the correct answer is what? Option D, which is all of the above. We have number two question. Which of the following is the correct mathematical equation for Shah's law at constant pressure? Now, what does Shah's law say? Shah was a very good friend of mine. He was my student. In case you don't know, Shah was my student. Now, Shah's law states that at constant temperature, at constant volume, at constant pressure, please take note. Shah's law states that at constant pressure, the volume is directly proportional to the temperature. It states that what? At constant pressure, the volume is directly proportional to temperature. The volume is directly proportional to what? Temperature at constant pressure. The pressure is constant. That is to say, if you hold the pressure constant, that means if the pressure is 5, increase in volume will lead to an increase in temperature. That is why we said it is directly proportional. For example, when you say your girlfriend is directly proportional to you, what does it mean? It means that both of you are what? The same. Are we getting it? If you increase one person, you increase the other one. If you beat one person, you beat the other person. Are you getting it? So like the way we beat some people's girlfriend or boyfriends. Are we getting it now? So that is what is applicable here also. The volume is inverse or is directly proportional to the temperature at constant pressure. That is the mathematical statement of what? The Shah's law. Now, if you want to remove the proportionality sign, this becomes what? V is equal to. Removing the proportionality sign, we say that whenever the proportionality sign is to be removed, what happens? You introduce equal to and introduce K. So we can say that this proportionality sign is equivalent, let me take it this way, to equal to and K. So in place of the proportionality sign, you put equal to and what? And K. So let's take it a little bit slower. In place of the proportionality sign, you put equal to and K. So this gives us V is equal to KT, isn't it? Now, what are we going to do? To look for K, we can divide both sides by T. So T cancel T. Your V over T is equals to K. And K will be equal to V over T. So any of these forms is the mathematical representation of the Shah's law. It's either you write it as V is directly proportional to T, or you can say that V is equal to KT, which is this one up, or you can say that your K is equals to V over T. Any of these will suffice for the mathematical representation of Shah's law. Like I said, Shah was a very, very good boy of mine. So I'm so happy today. I don't know why. I'm very, very happy. So the correct answer is, which of the following is the correct mathematical representation for Shah's law? We have A, V is directly proportional to T. That is it. Are we getting it? The other one is V is equals to T. That is not true, because what we have is V must be equal to KT and V is equals to K. That is wrong. And none of the above. None of the above is among. So none of the above automatically is what disqualifies. So the correct answer to this question is option A. V is directly proportional to T. Is that clear? Yeah, that is very, very clear. Mathematical representation of Shah's law is given by V is directly proportional to K, or directly proportional to T, where if you change proportionality sign, as I've said, is equal to what? K. Proportionality sign means equal to K. So we say V, in place of proportionality sign, we put what? Equal to what? K, then we will put what? T. To make k the solution of the formula, what do we do? Divide both sides by what? T, and then you have k is equals to v over t. Correct answer, option A. Next question says, equal volumes of all gases at the same temperature and pressure contains equal number of molecules. Is the statement of, you don't need to solve for this one. The correct answer is Avogadro's law. Whenever you heard that one, equal volume at constant temperature and pressure contain the same number of or equal number of molecules is the what? Avogadro's law. Are we getting it now? So we stated Schatz's law. Schatz's law says that the pressure is inversely, please take note of that, proportional to what? Volume. I mean, Boyle's law, rather. Boyle's law says that the pressure is inversely proportional to volume. Schatz's law states that the volume is directly proportional to temperature. The fourth question, the study of the flow of heat or any other form of energy into or out of a system undergoing physical or chemical change is called the study of the flow of heat or any other form of energy into or out of a system undergoing physical or chemical change is called what? Thermodynamics is the correct answer, which is option C. The correct answer, thermodynamics. Thermodynamics is the study of the flow of heat or any other form of energy into or out of the system as it undergoes physical or chemical transformation or change. Now, the next question rather says, the granules, or you can say zinc granules, reacting with dilute hydrochloric acid in an open beaker constitutes, we have zinc granules reacting with dilute hydrochloric acid in an open beaker constitutes. Now, I want to teach you something that is very important. Now, in thermodynamics, we have three types of systems. Now, before we talk about systems, we must understand something that is very, very important. There are some concepts that we must understand. In thermodynamics, we have what is called the universe. Now, the universe in thermodynamics means the system and the surrounding. Universe is equals to the system, let me use this, and the surrounding. That is what the universe is. That is to say, the system plus the surrounding gives you the universe. Now, what is the system and what is the surrounding? The system is the area of interest. The system is the what? Area of interest. For instance, let me look for something to make an illustration. Give me that bottle. Now, for instance, you have this bottle. Now, you keep, let's say, shock particles in this bottle. Now, those shock particles that are kept in this bottle is called the word the system. Why? The surrounding involves every other place around this place. Are we getting it? It's called the surrounding. Then we have the boundary. What is the boundary? The boundary is like any obstruction that defines the system and the surrounding. Are we getting it? Like the walls of this container is called the what? The boundary. Are we getting all the walls of the bottle? It's called the boundary. So we can say that the system is that area of interest. Is that area of what? Interest. The system is the area of interest. Like I said, let's assume you have a beaker like this with the zinc granule. The zinc inside and everything inside of this place is called the system. Why? From here like this, anywhere surrounding this system is called the what? Surrounding. Are we getting it now? That's called the surrounding. Now, we have different types of system. We have the open system, the closed system, and the isolated system. Now, any system that exchange matter with the surrounding and also exchange energy in the form of heat, work, or radiation is known as an open system. Are we getting it? It exchange matter. That means it exchange what is inside and also heat or any other form of energy is an open system. Then, if you take a look at what was given to you, say zinc granule in a beaker. The zinc inside the beaker. Now note, the beaker is what? Open. The beaker is open. And since the beaker is open, from what you will see said in an open beaker, it means that the answer is what? Open system. Why? Because it can share that matter with the environment because there is nothing what actually blocking it. It's open. And also, it can also share what? Energy. Are we getting it now? So, that is for open system. As time goes on, we get to understand what closed system. Or let me just explain. Now, for closed system, the surrounding is closed. The system is closed. It cannot exchange matter, but it can exchange what? Energy in the form of heat. For instance, let's assume you have your water, hot water, inside those iron cups. Now, you may cover that cup. There are some of these iron cups that are fancy that you can cover. Now, you may cover that cup in such a way that the vapor of the water will not escape into the surrounding. But when you touch the body of that cup, it will be very, very what? Hot. Are we getting it now? It will be very, very hot because it exchange what? Heat with the surrounding through the walls of the container. So any kind of system that exchange energy, radiation in the form of all that exchange energy in the form of work, heat or radiation with its surrounding, but do not exchange what is inside, that means the matter inside, is known as a closed system. Why the last one is an isolated system? Now, for isolated system, it does not exchange energy and it does not exchange what? Matter. For instance, when you put food flasks inside a particular flask, or when you put a food inside a food flask, what happens? That food will be there. When you touch the walls of the food flask, it's very, very cold. But when you open the food flask, it's very, very what? Hot. So you see that in that situation, the food is inside, covered. That system is not exchanging that food with the what? Surrounding. Secondly, when you touch the walls of that food flask, it's also what? Cold. The heat inside that food flask is not coming out to the surrounding. Such kind of system is known as what? Isolated system. So we've made mention of three systems. We said the first one is an open system. Open system is that system that does what? That exchange both matter, energy in the form of work, heat, and radiation to the surrounding. Closed system is the one that exchange only energy in the form of heat, work, and radiation, but does not exchange what? Matter. Why the isolated does not exchange any of them? Does not exchange matter, does not exchange what? Energy. So the correct answer to that question is what? Is an open system. Is an open system. The open system do not exchange energy. It exchange both energy and matter. And when you look at that zinc granule reacting with dilute hydrochloric acid in an open beaker, that open beaker suggests that there can be escape of the zinc granule out of the world surrounding, to the surrounding. And at the same time, the walls of that container has the probability of also what losing energy. Now, that is that. Now, the next question says, the first law of thermodynamics is the total energy of an isolated system remain constant though it may change from one form to another. That is very, very correct. Is among. Now, B, the total energy of a system and its surrounding remains constant. That is correct. C, whenever energy of one type disappears, equivalent amount of another type is produced. That is correct. And D, all of the above. The correct answer is D, which is all of the above. All are correct. Are we getting it? So whenever you see a question like this, you know that the correct answer is all of the above. Now the next question says, a closed system is one in which matter or a closed system is one that cannot transfer matter but transfer dash to and from its surrounding. It cannot transfer matter, but it can transfer dash to and from its surrounding. I explained this before, that a closed system is that system that cannot transfer matter, but can transfer energy in the form of heat, work, and radiation. Now, the options given to you are A, heat, B, walk. C, radiation. And D, all of the above. The correct answer is all of the above. All of the above are correct. Now, the next question says, the mathematical relation for the first law of thermodynamics is, now the mathematical relationship is changing E is equals to Q minus W, where Q is the work done into the system and W is the work that the system does on the surrounding. Now, please note, I'm answering these questions for you because you've done most of these things before. When I come to school, I'm going to teach you from the beginning. This one is past question sessions. That is why it is called video. Are we getting it now? So that you get intimated with the questions before the exam. So the correct answer to this question is this. Option A. This is the internal energy. It means that the internal energy of the system is equal to the energy that was supplied to the system minus the energy that the system gave out. So what we are just saying is the energy remaining, which is the internal energy, is equal to the total energy that you actually gave into the system minus the one that it has given out. And that is the statement or the mathematical representation of the first law of thermodynamics. Now, the next question says, the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 mole of a substance by 1 Kelvin is called, correct answer is molar heat capacity. Molar what? Heat capacity is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 mole of a substance by 1K molar heat capacity. Now, according to the numbering here is number 20, but next question. Which statement is correct interpretation of the enthalpy of a system? A. The total heat content of a system and constant pressure, which is equivalent to the internal energy plus PV energy. Now, that is the correct answer to that question. Which of the following is the enthalpy or interpretation of the enthalpy of a system? The total heat content of a system at constant pressure, which is equivalent to the internal energy plus PV energy. That is what the enthalpy is all about. Are we getting it now? The enthalpy is given as change in H. So we can say change in H is equals to change in E plus P change in V. This is the mathematical relation of enthalpy, and that is what is stated in that statement. So the correct answer to that question, whenever you see it, please note, the reason why I'm taking these questions like this is because they will be repeated. So whenever you see it, we don't need much explanation. Know that that is the correct answer to that question.